أفرأيت الذي تولى وأعطى قليلا وأكدى أعنده علم الغيب فهو يرى
تقال العثار العظام به ويعود الهوى ككبش ذبيح بذكر
One particular dimension of our personality that we have a hard time changing. He says about this person, he gives a little bit. What that means is he's charitable to an extent. وَأَكْدَى Then he slows down and قَطَعَ مِنْ أَعْطِيَتِهِ He stops giving. Allah is describing that human beings, even the ones who don't want to listen to anything about Islam, who don't want to hear what the Prophet have to say, they're also charitable people. They also feel like if they were asked to support some worthy cause, they would give to. If they see a child suffering, or even an animal suffering, they'll give, they'll support. Allah put that humanity inside of us. That's something all human beings share. So they do give. Charitability is there. But when it comes to, one way to interpret these ayat is, when it comes to other good things, they hold themselves back. So that dimension of our goodness, you figure, well, yeah, you know, I do drink. I do this, I do the other. Like you make a list of all the bad things you do. But then you say, you know, I do help out though. I do support some good causes. And you feel that because you're doing this, it should be able to compensate for all the other bad stuff that you're up to. وَأَكْدَى And when it comes to other good things, he slows down. Others have interpreted this to mean, I'm only going to give, but so much. So much that I don't feel bad anymore. Like, you know, somebody pulled up at a red light and a homeless person stuck their hand out. And, you could stick your hand in your wallet and pull out a 20. Or you could look in the cup holder for some quarters. You have a choice. So you go for the quarters. At least I gave something. So he gave to an extent, but then held himself back. You give, and you feel that now that you've given, you can slow down the other good things you're doing. This is good enough, I'm a good person, I mean, I give. That should be good enough. And then you appease yourself, you tell yourself a story in which you are, or I am a good person. So what if I, mess up here and there a little bit? I minimize my mistakes, and I maximize in my mind the good that I do, right? And it makes me feel good about myself. And so Allah Azza wa Jalla then asks this person who thinks this way, and I hope you and I don't become these people. Allah asks this person a personal question. Does he possess knowledge of the unseen that he can himself see? A really strange question. A person gives a little bit, feels good about themselves, withholds themselves from doing other good deeds, and Allah asks them the question, do you see the unseen? What does that question have to do with his behavior? You see, when you decide that these good deeds are good enough for Allah, or that bad stuff is not that bad, you're speaking on behalf of Allah. You and I are speaking on behalf of how Allah is going to judge. Oh, Allah and I, we have a special relationship, He gets me. He'll understand. Really? He told you this, that He'll understand? Or did you tell yourself that story? Allah is actually asking a very bold question because you and I become very bold. We start assuming we can speak on behalf of how Allah will judge us. You know, there are two extremes, and I want you to be aware of both of these extremes. They're both very lethal. Islam is about, the Quran especially, is about balance. It's right in the middle. One extreme is someone says, man, you know what, I'm going to hell. I know. Nothing I do is good enough. I wish I was better, but I'm not. You become hopeless and you assume that Allah will throw you into hell. And on the other extreme, what is being described here, is you become delusionally hopeful. The little that you and I do, we assume, should be way more than enough. I'm covered. I don't have to make any other changes. I'm in my comfort zone. I just want to leave you with one ayah. This Allah at the end clarifies, by the end of this conversation, He clarifies, in fact, what Allah does for you. Allah is the one who makes you wealthy. Allah is the one who gives you independence. Allah is the one who takes care of your problem. And Allah is the one who actually removed that problem from you. It's not your efforts. So when you're giving a little, you're giving a little from what Allah gave you. It's not from your account, it's from the account Allah filled. That job you got wasn't because of your resume, because of my resume, it's because Allah allowed for that job to happen. That opportunity to happen. And I pray to Allah Azza wa Jal, we become of those who are given laughter, who are given joy in life, because we accepted that Allah is the one who gives. Allah will give us in this life and He will give us in